Now let's keep it to matters COVID and go to Parliament, where members on the Health Committee are concerned at the price of the COVID-19 vaccine that is being supplied by the British or UK company, the Oxford AstraZeneca. According to the chairperson of the committee, Dr. Michael Bukenya, the Ministry of Health and government for that matter should be able to renegotiate the price of the vaccine to be able to be accessed by all Ugandans.
This is the money that is building cities like Switzerland.
Although Uganda joined the COVAX facility that committed to providing the country with COVID-19 vaccines, these vaccines will only be able to cover 20% of Uganda's population, meaning the government has to devise all possible means of covering a bigger part of the population. The concern now is on the cost at which the government has to buy these vaccines. The chairperson of the Health Committee of Parliament, Dr. Michael Bukenya, said according to the Minister of Health, Uganda will pay $7 per dose of the AstraZeneca vaccine, a price which is 20% more than South Africa and roughly triple that being paid by the European Union.
The cost of the vaccine that was introduced in Parliament was $7 per dose. Yet the international cost that is being shown everywhere is $4.
The legislators insist that the Minister of Health needs to further negotiate the price for the good of the country.
This issue was raised in Parliament to the Minister, and she accepted that they were doing negotiations and the price would actually go down.
The other alternative they are giving the government is that it should consider lobbying sister governments within the region for the pooled procurement of this vaccine. They hope this will help increase the bargaining power to get the vaccine at a lower cost per dose.
Can we look at ways of bargaining so that we are given this AstraZeneca at a lower price?
Early this week, the Minister for Health, Dr. Jane Ruth Acheng, confirmed that over 30,000 Ugandans have so far been vaccinated. This story was compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news in Kampala.